हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू सक्सेस एजुटेक. थैंक यू फॉर योर पॉजिटिव रिस्पांस टू माय प्रीवियस लेक्चर. इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टडीड अबाउट इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन विच वाज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक ऑफ लॉज ऑफ मोशन. आई होप एवरी स्टूडेंट इज टेकिंग एडवांटेज ऑफ दिस लॉकडाउन पीरियड टू गेन मोर एंड मोर नॉलेज एंड क्लैरिफाई एवरी डाउट. आई ऑल्सो रिक्वेस्ट स्टूडेंट दोज हु आर नॉट स्टडिंग शुड स्टार्ट स्टडिंग विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी टाइम. With this, let us continue with the chapter 1 of Laws of Motion, lecture 4, which is Uniform Circular Motion. And as also said in the previous lecture, we are going to deal with the numericals based on equation of motion, the three kinematical equation of motion given by Newton. Uniform circular motion, it is a type of a motion. We already defined motion as a movement of an object. Whenever a force is applied to an object, it moves. That movement is called as a motion. Can you see the tick-tock clock over here? For our clock, there is a hour hand, there is a minute hand, there is a second hand. Consider this one is the second hand of the clock. Observe the tip of the second hand of a clock. What can you say about its velocity and speed? We have to conclude something about velocity and speed. Talking about the speed, a clock which is very periodic, we know that it is a periodic object. So its speed is constant. Its speed is constant. When we talk about a minute hand, the minute hand of a clock moves at a speed of 1 revolution per hour. The second hand of a clock, it complete 1 turn in 1 second. Just as move 1 turn in 1 second. Therefore, the second hand of a clock is moving at a speed of 1 revolution per minute. It moves with a speed of 1 revolution per minute, and it is a constant speed. So what we can say about the tip of the second hand of a clock, that it is covering a circular trajectory. It is covering a circular trajectory, that too periodically with a constant speed. So the speed of the tip is constant, yeah, but the direction of its displacement and therefore its velocity is constantly changing. So when we talk about velocity, it is constantly changing. When we talk about speed, it is constant. As the tip is moving along a circular path, it is called as a uniform circular motion. The word uniform is because of this constant speed. As the speed is constant, it is a uniform circular motion. When the speed is not constant and the object is moving along a circular path, we will only call it as a circular motion, not uniform. Can you give some more examples of such motion which is having a circular motion? Yeah. A rotating fan. Everybody knows how the fan is rotating. It is moving along a circular path. When you talk about that object, it is moving along a circular path. The wheel of a bicycle. The spinning top. In the childhood, we used to spin the top. The top will move round and round. It is called as a circular motion. Motion of the satellite around the earth. It is revolving around the earth. Rotation and revolution of the earth. These all are periodic in nature and they cover a circular trajectory, a circular path. They move along a circular path. So the reason we call it as a circular motion. And when these objects are having a constant speed with an increasing velocity, at the time we call it as a uniform circular motion. Just observe all this figure. In this figure, there is a square, there is a pentagon, there is a hexagon. Okay. Whenever you take a turn, you have to change the direction. 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also you need to change the direction. Just what they have asked is, draw a rectangular path, okay. Place the tip of your pencil on the middle of any side of the square path. You have to place a pencil over here somewhere. You have to place a pencil over here at the tip of the pencil on the middle of any side. Note how many times you have to change the direction. See, 1, 2, 3, and you come back here 4 times. When you place the tip of your pencil at the middle, you will change the direction 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 to come back to the original position. Now repeat the action for pentagon, hexagon, octagon, and note the number of times you have to change the direction. When you keep on increasing the sides of the polygon, what will happen? That number of times you have to change the direction. So once if you increase the number of sides of a polygon to infinity, if you increase it to infinity, what will happen? You have to change the direction infinity times. You have to change the direction infinity times. So as you convert the number of direction to infinity, direction of a polygon, number of sides of a polygon to infinity, sure shot it will get converted into a circle, because they say, this shows that as we increase the number of sides, we have to keep changing direction more and more times, and when we increase the number of sides to infinity, the polygon becomes a circle. So in the circle you have to change the direction infinity times, and therefore we get a circle, and that becomes a uniform circular motion if the speed is constant. Otherwise you can call it as a circular motion. So we have to cover a trajectory, circular trajectory, in order to call it as a circular motion. And in circular motion, the direction will keep on changing, and as the direction changes, the velocity will keep on changing. When an object is moving with a constant speed at a circular path, the change in the velocity is only due to the change in the direction. Yeah, whenever it is covering a circular path, as we saw here, we have to change the direction how many times? Infinity number of times. So when we change the direction infinity number of times, it becomes a circular path. It becomes a circular motion. The change in the velocity is only due to the change in the direction. So there is a, and when there is a change in the velocity, we know that the definition of acceleration is change in velocity per unit time. So it becomes an accelerated motion. The circular motion is also called as a accelerated motion. When an object moves with a constant speed along a circular path, the motion is called as a uniform circular motion. Whenever there is a constant speed, it, you may call it as a uniform circular motion. Example, the motion of a stone in a sling or that of any point on a bicycle wheel when they are in uniform motion. The bicycle of a wheel, it completes a circular path, so it is a circular motion. The stone, motion of a stone in a sling, you take a thread, tie the stone to one end and just rotate it, that motion will come under a circular motion, and you, when you keep on rotating it with a constant speed, that comes under uniform motion. If an object moving along a circular path of radius r take time t to come back to its starting position. Circular path means you have to start at one point and come back to the same point. You have to come back to the same point. So displacement comes out to be, displacement will comes out to be zero, but distance will be there. Displacement will be zero, but because displacement is like the distance between the starting point and the ending point. Your starting point is same, your ending point is same. So the distance is zero between the starting point and the ending point, which you call it as a displacement, but there is a distance. That distance will be equal to the circumference of the circle, and that is 2 pi r. So when you talk about speed, we know that speed is equal to distance upon time, and that distance is circumference for a circular path. So it comes out to be 2 pi r upon time. So circumference of time upon time is the formula. This is a formula for finding out the speed of a circular motion. Now can you find out more examples of circular motion in day-to-day life? Yes students, can you find out more examples? I request students to kindly find out more examples of uniform circular motion, and kindly comment those in the comment section. I will surely refer to it. Determining the direction of velocity in a uniform circular motion. Now we come to know what is a circular motion. What is a uniform circular motion? When a constant speed, when the object is moving with a constant speed with the circular trajectory, it is called as a uniform circular motion. And now the direction of the velocity we need to find out. How to do it? Take a circular disc. Everybody know the disc? Yeah. Take a circular disc and put a 5 rupee coin at a point along its edge. Make it move around its axis, putting a pin through it. Take a disc, make an axis over here, insert a pin, and like a top, try to rotate it. When the disc is moving at a higher speed, the coin will be thrown. You have to keep a coin over here. And when this disc is moving, at that time, what will happen? The coin will be thrown away. It will be thrown away. It will be like, if it is here, it will be thrown away like this when it is moving in this direction. Note the direction in which it is thrown off. Repeat the action, placing the coin at different points along the edge of the circle, and observe the direction in which the coin is thrown off. that direction in which the coin is thrown off will be the direction of the uniform circular motion, velocity of uniform circular motion. The coin will be thrown off in the direction of the tangent, which is perpendicular to the radius of the circle. That will be clear in this diagram. See, if the object, if the disc is moving in this direction and you have placed a 5 rupee coin over here, when you move this disc with a high speed, what will happen? That coin will come and it will be thrown out. It will be thrown out. So what it will be, this is a circle and there will be a tangent to the circle. This tangent to the circle, the point at which the coin is thrown out, that tangent to the circle is the direction of the velocity of the circular motion. And these all are the direction of the velocity of the circular motion. And this is infinity number of times. You can find out this direction at each point of the circle, at each point on the circumference of the circle. In this direction, it is the direction of the force. It is direction of the force and acceleration because of which the disc is moving, this directions. And these are the tangents are the direction of the velocity of the circular motion. So students, you have to simply do this small experiment to find out the velocity, direction of the velocity. And when the coin moves along a circular path, the direction of the motion is changing at every point. So you will get infinity number of times the direction, because the points, whenever you change the direction infinity number of times, it comes out to be a circular path. Now we are going to proceed with the examples of equation of motion. Let us see. It's very simple examples, very simple numericals based on equation of motion. Just you have to use any one of the formula out of the three formula, whichever given quantity, according to that you have to take the three formulas, three equation, which are V is equal to U plus AT, S is equal to UT plus half AT square, V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. Depending, first you should clearly write down whatever given in the question, and then you have to check out which formula to be used and you will get the answer. Simple question they ask, just to find out the distance, displacement, initial velocity, final velocity, acceleration, that is it. An athlete is running on a circular track. He runs a distance of 400 meter in 25 seconds. Before returning to his original position, what is his average speed and velocity? So you need to find out the average speed and velocity. You know, speed is equal to distance upon time, velocity is equal to displacement upon time. Kindly note down the formula immediately on taking a pen and a paper. He runs a distance of 400 meter. You know the what is the value of the distance, and it is a circular track, therefore displacement will be zero because you have to start at one point and at the same point. So circular track is there, displacement will be zero, displacement and distance will be 400 meter given, and the time is 25 seconds. Note down the given quantities, substitute the values in this formula, you will get the answer. Example number 2. An aeroplane taxis on the runway for 30 seconds with an acceleration of 3.2 meter per second square. Whenever the value of acceleration is given, you have to take that value. If the value of acceleration is not given, at that time you have to take the value of acceleration as 9.8 meter per second square. But here they have given the value of acceleration. And in case whenever they ask you to find out the value of acceleration, at that time also you should not take this value. You should take the formula and find out the value after substituting the given quantities. An aeroplane taxis on the runway for 30 seconds with an acceleration of 3.2 meter per second square before taking off. How much distance would it have covered on the runway? You have to find out the distance at the time. The t is equal to 30 seconds, it is given. So after writing down the given quantities, we come to know that the second kinematical equation, which is S is equal to UT plus half AT square. Here we have to take the value of U as zero because the aeroplane is going to start. So start means initially it was at rest. Initially it was at rest means initial velocity will be equal to zero. So we have to find out S. We have to find out the value of S. S is equal to U, we know T value they have given, plus half acceleration they have given, time also they have given. Just we have to take a pen and paper and do the calculation, you will get the answer. A kangaroo can jump 2.5 meter vertically. See, the kangaroo is going to jump from ground to up. That means its direction of movement is like this, whereas the acceleration of earth is in the downward direction, and he is going to, the activity of moving is from ground to top portion. And here the final velocity, the activity is only of jumping, so final velocity will become equal to zero. A kangaroo can jump 2.5 meter vertically. What will be its initial velocity of the kangaroo? He is jumping means he is starting with some velocity, so there will be some initial velocity, and he is jumping and reaching a height of 2.5 meter. So at the height of 2.5 meter, its final velocity will be zero and then it will come down again. But the activity of jumping is given here, so we will take, we have to take that at 2.5 meter. At 2.5 meter, the final velocity will be equal to zero and there is some initial velocity over here, and the acceleration is in the direction opposite to that of the velocity, correct? So after writing the given quantity, A is not given acceleration, but we know the acceleration of Earth is 9.8 meter per second square. They have given the distance, that is 2.5 meter. Velocity, final velocity is zero. They have asked us to find out the initial velocity. And the relation of all this comes in the kinematical equation V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. Just substitute the value. And the negative sign is given to the acceleration. The reason is the acceleration is in the downward direction, whereas the activity of jumping is in the upward direction. The velocity is going in the upward direction. So the both of them are having a opposite relationship. So the reason the acceleration is taken as the negative. If the acceleration and velocity both are in the same direction, you should take it in a falling body will have the acceleration and velocity in the same direction. But here is a jumping body. So the reason the acceleration and velocity are in opposite direction, so you should take the value of acceleration as minus 9.8. Substitute the values and get the answer. You will come to know the answer comes out to be U is initial velocity is equal to 7 meter per second. Example number 4. A motor boat starts from rest and moves with a uniform acceleration. It was at rest. So immediately you can note down that the initial velocity is equal to 0. If it attains a velocity of 15 meter per second, if attains means it is a final velocity, 15 meter per second. In 5 seconds, time is given to you. Calculate the acceleration and distance. You have to calculate the acceleration distance. So acceleration you need to calculate. That means you cannot take it as 9.8 meter per second square. So to find out the acceleration, we have the simple formula. Final velocity minus initial velocity upon t. Upon time, just substitute the value, you will get the value of acceleration from the second equation of kinematic, which is s is equal to ut plus half a t square. After writing the given quantity, we come to know that we can use this formula to find out the distance. S you need to find out. So s you need to find out, you should first get into the mind that s is equal to what it is there. So this is the equation. You have to, it was at rest means u is equal to u, 0. You will substitute, time is given, half a, we have find out. And t square, time is given, just substitute the value, it comes out, the distance comes out to be 37.5 meter. In shorts, that we have studied uniform circular motion, that we have defined that the uniform circular motion is a motion with a circular trajectory having a constant speed but with continuous change in the direction. There will be a continuous change in the direction so that there is a change in the velocity, and hence it is called as what? It is called as an accelerated motion. You can also, once again, go through all the examples, solve it taking a pen and paper, and kindly share more and more examples of uniform circular motion as a homework in the comment section. Your doubts and your homework will be surely referred and solved. Refer through the examples of the circular motion given over here. Kindly go through all the examples of the circular motion and also give some examples from your side. We can see lot many examples of uniform circular motion in our day-to-day life. So students, thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. In the next lecture, we are going to proceed further with other topics of laws of motion. Do study. All the best.